Part two. Now we're talking about the red flags of Cindy Anthony. Are there any? We know that more than a week before picking up the car, after the notice. The notice was mailed on the 3rd of July, and they didn't pick up the car until July 16th. That's way, way too many days. And despite George and Cindy's theatrics over the smell of death in the car, in Casey's car, neither Melich nor other arriving patrolmen, those who were people who were on duty, who walked right beside the car and right next to the car, never smelled anything. Both George and Cindy used the awful smell routine at every opportunity to make an impression, and an indelible impression. But despite describing a decomposing body in Casey's car, Cindy goes to work rather than calling law enforcement. Now, she may have had a loss of her own daughter and a loss of her grandchild. She's got so-called evidence there of somebody died in the car. But she's not worried that it could be her daughter or Kaylee. She just goes to work. And she puts on a little show at work. And she has been, now that we know this, that she has been setting a stage here, we can also see that Cindy has been talking to her co-workers throughout that whole week, setting them up for the missing granddaughter. So I'm pretty much eliminating all this footwork that Cindy did in order to get the desired testimony from co-workers. And it wasn't until it was 7 hours between the time of picking up the car and before Cindy calls 911. 7 hours. Later testing reveals no evidence of a dead body had been in that car. Well, that makes sense. They checked the wrong car, is what. Let's see, during the 7 hours, Cindy nonchalantly cleans the car, cleans the doll's face. This is all for effect. Casey's pants washed, never calling 911, despite the possibility of some deaths. And never reported, and she herself never reported Kaylee missing or, you know, for 7 hours. Think about it. Could you not report something in 7 hours, and yet you have this odor of a dead body in the car? And mind you, both of these people are either college graduates or college educated, both George and Cindy. And yet we have Cindy doing a lot of theatrics during this time. We have her going and saying, here is this college graduate saying that pizza draws maggots. You know, all sorts of absolutely. And what she's doing, she's playing a part of the distraught grandmother. And you know, she's absolutely playing to the camera all the time. Now, oh man.